Students, welcome to our medical diagnostic class, that is the Good Samaritan School online classes of class 11 medical diagnostic students. Okay, already we have started with the topic of physical examination of urine, and only two parts are left here: specific gravity and pH measurement in urine. So how the specific gravity can be measured in urine? By two ways it can be measured: with the help of urinometer and with the help of refractometer. Now just with the help of the videos, two videos, okay, I will show you how to use the urinometer and how to use the refractometer. Let's see.
Beaker containing 50 to 100 ml of distilled water, 225 ml of measuring cylinder, 1 to 2 urinometer and urine sample. The principle of urinometer is very simple. Specific gravity of water is about 1.000, and to cross check the specific gravity of urine, we have to tally it with the help of water. So in disease case, the specific gravity of urine may be increased or decreased. The conditions are mentioned in this principle section. So let's start the practical by measuring the temperature of sample water. We have taken 25 ml of water in 25 ml of measuring cylinder, and the temperature of water has been recorded with the using of either digital or analog thermometer. The water temperature should be 20 degrees centigrade for a specific gravity of water. If the temperature of water exceed or below from 20 degrees centigrade, please use the following calculation to rectify or justify the temperature record. So let's start the practical with a sample of water. We have taken a urinometer, and slightly with the rotation, we introduce it to the 25 ml of water containing in the measuring cylinder. The care should be taken that the urinometer should not touch or adhere to the wall of measuring cylinder. After a few time, let's take its lower meniscus to the side of glass wall or side of measuring cylinder. Note it down. As you see the side angle or the lower meniscus of water, you will see this. And if you take the reading from upside of the measuring cylinder, it will be around 1.00 and 0. So specific density of water or specific gravity of water is always 1 at a 20 degree centigrade. So this is a standard. Now repeat the procedure with the sample of urine. We have taken a sample of urine with 25 ml, and we are going to repeat the same procedure with a urine sample. We have slightly rotate the urinometer and allow it to freely rotate and freely stop on measuring cylinder. Once the rotation will stop, the care should be also taken here that the urinometer should not adhere or stick to the wall of measuring cylinder. Just after that, take a reading from the lower meniscus side by side of measuring cylinder. You will find the reading about 18 unit in this scale. We are talking about the 18 unit. So we have to add this 18 unit to the total of 1. So it will be a 0.18 plus 1.000. So equal is equal to 1.0018. To make you better understand, we are just repeating this both procedure at a simultaneous. You can see there are two measuring cylinder containing water and urine sample. We have inserted two urinometer on those sample. As you can see, the density of water and urine are very much different. Density of urine is more than density of water. It is indicated by the level of urinometer, as you can see on the screen. So these are two different parameters we have used for the evaluation of density. The result cam is the normal specific density of water is 1 and other you can see. Please do like, share and subscribe. Solid.
Now in the next part I will show you how to use the refractometer.
Mr. Pipette, right in your cup, you're going to put 2 to 3 drops of urine using a transfer pipette. Right in there's a little like sort of circle hole in underneath the glass of the refractometer. Alright, so make sure you get it onto that hole. And then you're going to close the lid back over it, and you're going to see that the urine gets kind of spread out across that piece of glass on the top of the refractometer. Once that happens, you can then take the refractometer, hold it up to your eye, like imagine it's sort of like a telescope, and just walk underneath of it some sort of bright overhead light. All right, so make sure that you are under a light, because it's going to use that light to shine through the liquid, and so it's easy for you to see what the specific gravity is. All right, so again, walk under the light, look into the refractometer like it were a telescope, and then you're going to look for some different scales on the refractometer. On this particular refractometer, the specific gravity scale is on the lower left-hand side. So all you're going to do is look at the lower left scale where the specific gravity is and look for where the black line goes across the scale and read off the scale. And that is the specific gravity of the urine. All right.
So this is up to the specific gravity of urine, how to measure it, okay, with the help of urinometer and refractometer. Now, why should we measure the specific gravity? What is the importance of that? The specific gravity should be measured in both first, okay, with the help of urinometer, that you have already seen in the distilled water and in the urine also. The normal specific gravity, that can be varying from the random collection of urine and the 24-hour urine collection. In random urine, it can be 1.003 to 1.035, whereas in 24-hour collection, it can be 1.015 to 1.030. Now, in case of polyuria, you already know what the polyuria is. Polyuria means when the volume of urine excretion will be more than the normal range. Okay. So, in which condition the polyuria can be seen? Basically, in condition of diabetes mellitus and diabetes insipidus. But in case of diabetes insipidus, the specific gravity will be low. But in case of diabetes mellitus, the specific gravity will be high. Why? Because in case of diabetes mellitus, the patient can have the glucose present in urine. Okay. But in case of diabetes insipidus, as there is no glucose present in the urine, so the specific gravity will be low. Now, what is called as the hypersthenuria? Hypersthenuria, that means there will be higher specific gravity. So, when the higher specific gravity in urine can be seen, in which conditions? That can be dehydration, eclampsia, proteinuria, diabetes mellitus and a lipoid nephrosis. Okay. Now, isosthenuria. What is the meaning of isosthenuria? When the specific gravity in the urine will be always 1.010. You have seen in the last slide that in both of the cases, random urine and in 24-hour collection, what will happen? The specific gravity will differ in normal cases. But in case of isosthenuria, always it will be fixed specific gravity. And what clinical condition it will show? That is the indicator of poor tubular reabsorption. Okay, poor tubular reabsorption. That means the distal convoluted tubule and the collecting duct of the patient, that is not working properly. And the last point is called as the hypostenuria. Hypostenuria means when there will be low specific gravity rather than the normal range. And it can be found in the pyelonephritis, hypertension, protein malnutrition and diabetes insipidus. If the patient is taking the diuretic medicine or any kind of natural diuretics such as alcohol and coffee, then also low specific gravity can be seen. Now come to the last point, that is the pH. So how can you measure the pH of the urine? You can use the simple pH paper that usually you are using in your biology lab or chemistry lab. Simple pH paper you have to put in the urine, and after when it will be soaked with urine, automatically the pH paper will change its color, and with the help of the outside color range, you have to find out what is the normal pH, means it is belonging the normal pH, or the urine is acidic or alkaline. Now, usually the normal urine pH range is from 4.5 to 8. Okay, the pH values are reported, that is the example as that is 6.0. That means all the time the urine pH will be quite acidic in nature. Now the analyzer method. Analyzer method means where there will be two ranges will be given. Okay. One range will show the maximum value and another range will be showing the minimum value. With the help of the video, I will show you this method. And in the urine pH normal range, that is 6 to 7 QDX, that is means when you are using the urine strip usually, okay. And visual test, that can be ranges from 5 to 9. Now let's see how we can use the analyzer method. Now what will be the clinical significance, okay, if the pH range will change, okay. The freshly voided normal urine, that is slightly acidic in nature, and it can range from 4.6 to 7. But if there will be higher protein intake, or if the body is following the acidic condition, then the urine can be acidic. And if the person is taking the especially the citrus food or high amount of vegetable, or if the body is following the excessive vomiting or alkaline condition, then the urine pH can be alkaline in nature. So from next class we will start with the chemical examination of urine. Thank you very much.